हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी ए प्ले नेम्ड द प्ले बॉय ऑफ द वेस्टर्न वर्ल्ड। दिस प्ले इज ए थ्री एक्ट प्ले रिटन बाय आयरिश प्ले राइट जॉन मिलिंगटन सिंस एंड इट वाज फर्स्ट परफॉर्म्ड एट द एबी थिएटर विच इज इन डब्लिन ऑन 26 January 1907। This drama is all set in Michael James Flaherty's public house in County Mayo on the west coast of Ireland during the early 19th century. Early 20th century. It tells the story of Christy Mahon, a young man who is running away from his farm, claiming he has killed his father. The story we will read out. The entire play is set in a public house, or pub we can say, on the wild coast of Mayo, outside a village in northwestern Ireland, circa 1907. Peggin Mikey, daughter of the alehouse owner, sits alone in the pub, writing a letter to order supplies for her upcoming wedding to Sean Keogh. Her father, Michael James, has left her for the evening while he attends a wake. Sean Keogh enters, remarking upon the frightening darkness outside. Peggin asks him to stay with her since the night makes her nervous as well. But Sean refuses, claiming it would be improper for him to be alone with her until they are wed. However, he offers to send the widow queen to stay with her. Sean then reveals that he heard a man outside wailing from a ditch. Michael James enters along with his friend Philly and Jimmy. They are drunk and have not yet left for the wake. Michael James demands Sean stay with Peggin, but Sean refuses. Fearing the disapproval of the parish priest, Sean flees before the man can trap him, but quickly returns to tell them that he saw a face looking up out of the ditch. Christy Mahon, frightened and dirty, enters the pub, a shy young man. He simply wishes to warm himself by the fire, but soon enough reveals that he is on the run from the police. He tries to avoid talking about it, but the man pesters him until he admits that he killed his father. The group is getting impressed by this news, and to meet a man who could kill his own father, Michael James offers him a job on the spot, noting that Christy could keep Peggy in company this evening. Michael, Philly and Jimmy then leave for their wake, and a very intrigued Peggy chases Sean away. Peggin admires Christy, complimenting him on his physique, his face, his speech, and his courage. Christy swells with unfamiliar pride. Widow Queen appears. Having heard about Christy from Sean, the widow tries to seduce him, but Peggin insults and sends her off. As she leaves, however, the widow refers to Peggin's impending nuptial with Sean. This news devastates Christy, since he has fallen for her. However, she assures him she would never marry a coward like Sean, and then heads off to bed. Before he falls asleep, Christie muses to himself that he would have killed his father much sooner if he had known it would bring him such respect and fortune. Now, act number second. Three village girls arrive the next morning to see the man they have heard gossip about. They giggle and flirt with him until Widow Quinn arrives, announcing that she has registered Christie for a sports competition being held later on the beach. The girls joke that the widow and Christie would make a fine match. As they eat breakfast, Christie tells more about the murder, about how he rebelled when his father promised him to a widow whom he did not want to marry. When his father lifted a scythe, as their argument grew vicious, Christie struck back with a spade, hitting the old man on the head and killing him. Pagin enters and chases the woman out. Jealous, she accuses Christie of flirting, which he denies. The two exchange kind, tender words. They are falling in love. Sean and Widow Quinn re-enter and alert Pagin that her sheep have wandered off. Pagin rushes out, leaving them alone. Sean offers Christie a one-way ticket to America and all his fine clothes if he promises to leave the village. Christie rejects his offer, but the widow encourages him to try on Sean's clothes anyway. Christie agrees and leaves the room to change. Once Christie is gone, Sean promises to give the widow animals and wealth if she can find a way to interfere with Christie and Pagin's affair. The widow strikes a deal with Sean, promising to lure Christie into marrying her, not Pagin. Content, Sean leaves. Christie struts back in wearing Sean's clothes, but staggers back when he sees the spirit of his murdered dad outside the window. He hides just as Old Mahon, his father, enters. Old Mahon, a bandage round his bloodied head, describes Christie and then asks whether the widow has seen someone matching that description. The widow sends Mahon off to the docks, claiming she saw the boy waiting aboard a steamer. Mahon exits. Christie panics over his father's resurrection. Knowing that Pagin loves him for his murderous heroism, he worries she will leave him. He begs the widow to help him, which she agrees to do in exchange for privileges once he becomes master of the pub. The girls who visited earlier arrive to lead Christie down to the beach for the sports competition. Alone, the widow admits that Christie will eventually turn to her once the truth comes out and Pagin drops him. Act number third. Jimmy and Flea enters the empty pub, discussing how Christie has dominated the competition. They also admit that his constant boasting about his patricide annoys them. Old Mahon re-enters the pub, showing the man his wound. He asks again after his son. Right as the man begins to grow suspicious, Widow Quinn enters and confides to Jimmy and Philly that Mahon is crazy and has co-opted Christie's story for attention. When the man tries to interrogate Mahon further, the widow interjects to distract them. When the cheering from beach reaches the pub, Mahon looks out to widow to see the competition's champion, Christie. The widow convinces him that he is seeing things because of his head injury, and he anxiously leaves to admit himself to an insane asylum. Jimmy and Philly leave with him. Christie and Peggy enter with the crowd who celebrate Christie and then leave to watch the final competition on the beach. Alone now with Peggy, Christie proposes marriage and she accepts. Michael James, still drunk from the wake, enters with Sean, now perturbed about Christie's influence on his daughter. Michael insists she will marry Sean. Peggy defies her father and announces her intention to marry Christie. And Michael encourages Sean to fight Christie for her. When Sean covertly refuses, Michael decides to bless Christie and Peggy's match. Outside, a cry goes up as old Mahon bursts into the pub, rushing at Christie and knocking him down. When the older man reveals the truth, Peggy repudiates Christie. He then begs mercy from her and the crowd, but they will not grant it. Peggy urges Mahon to take his son away, but Christie resists Mahon. The crowd eggs on the fight between father and son until Christie turns on them with a spade. He then chases his father from the pub, the spade held high. Everyone rushes out to watch. Off stage, there is a loud cry and then silence. Christie stumbles back in dazed. Widow Queen follows, urging Christie to run since the crowd has turned against him. But Christie believes that Peggy will make him back now that he has actually killed his father. He is wrong. From the doorway, Michael, Philly, and Peggy throw a loop of rope around Christie, confining his arms and torso. Christie asks Peggy whether she will take him back, but she asserts there is a difference between a galvanous story and a dirty deed. Writhing on the floor, Christie threatens to kill them and bites Sean in the leg. Peggy burns Christie with a hot poker. Worked up, Christie conjures the welcome he shall receive from Satan once he has been hanged. But then Mahon crawls back in, demanding to know why his son is bound. He releases Christie, who then asks whether the man has returned to be killed a third time. Old Mahon tells the group that he and Christie will talk of County Mayo's villainy for years to come. However, Christie will not live peacefully with Mahon, whom he pushes roughly, declaring that his departure is that of a gallant captain with his heathen slave. Old Mahon is amazed and delighted by this change in his son. They then live together. Sean approaches Peggy to remind her of their wedding engagement. She boxes Sean's ear and sends him out, crying wildly. She laments that she has lost the only playboy of the Western world. Thank you.